Let's analyze the case when both source and observer are moving and Doppler's effect is accounted. Here you can see if there's a source having a frequency n0 hertz and in front of source say there is an observer. And if both are considered to be moving, say source is moving with the speed Vs and observer is moving with the speed Vo. In this situation, we can directly club the relations which we have studied in previous two sections. Here, due to the motion of source, the apparent wavelength changes. Here, wavelength will be written as C minus Vs by n0. And due to motion of observer, the relative speed of sound, as the sound is traveling at a speed C. So, apparent speed of sound with respect to observer will be C plus V0. So, your apparent frequency heard can be directly written as C plus V0 by lambda apparent, because lambda apparent is the length of one oscillation which is approaching the observer. And in 1 second, C plus V0 meter length will be absorbed by the observer. So, this can be written as C plus V0 by C minus Vs by n0. So, your n apparent can be given as n0 C plus Vo by C minus Vs. Now, this is the relation which is used here. And in general, we can use an expression whether source can move towards or away, observer can also move towards or away. So, in this situation, we know well when source and observer are approaching, the frequency will increase. When these are receding, the frequency will decrease. So, in general, expression for apparent frequency received by observer can be given as this general expression. We can write an apparent is equals to n0 C plus minus Vo divided by C plus minus Vs. In this situation, we'll choose positive or negative sign depending upon the velocity of observer and source. If say observer is moving toward the source, it will receive higher frequency. So, in numerator, we choose positive sign. If observer is moving away, it will receive a lesser frequency. So, we choose negative sign in numerator. Similarly, if source is approaching, the frequency received will increase due to approach. So, in denominator, we choose negative sign because decreasing denominator will result in increase in frequency. And if source is receding away, this will result in decrease in frequency. So, in denominator, we choose positive sign as increasing denominator will decrease the frequency. So, this is the direct relation we can use in various cases rather than using step-by-step analysis for each and every case. We'll directly use this expression for finding apparent frequency detected or heard by observer due to motion in observer and source by accounting Doppler's effect.